Hello guys, thank you very much for joining in, and I'm back with one more exciting session with one of my student. Her name is Bhakti, and she is going to be sharing her journey, her experience of clearing FRM level 1. Okay, she appeared for the exam in Jan 2021, and this video is primarily being created for the students who are going to be appearing for the exam in the future in July and November, so that they can get some insight on how a student has appeared and cleared the exam. Okay. And before we start the conversation, let us have a quick introduction of you. So Bhakti, if you could give the audience a brief about yourself, what you were doing before you started FRM, and now what you are doing.
I still am, but I was in first year when I thought of getting started with FRM. And right now I'm in my third year. I am also currently studying for CA.
Yep. CFA. Okay. So for the benefit of the audience, there was some technical issue. So just I'll repeat. She was in the first year of her examination, the college, when she gave the FRM level 1 exam. And now she's into third year, and she's also going to appear for the CFA level 1 in the near future. Right. So Bhakti, first of all, thank you very much for joining in and putting your time to this entire session and sharing your experience. Okay. And now let me ask you a few of the questions which I generally ask my students, because that will help the other guys to know how to prepare. Okay. So few basic questions. So when you started the preparation for FRM, what was your thought process? Okay. Why did you went for FRM as a student going for the who's going to start the graduation journey?
So I always, like every one of us know that everyone is graduating right now. Hmm. We look around, there's no differentiating between any of us. Everyone is doing their bachelor's and then they're doing their master's. Right. But I wanted to stand out of the crowd, right? I should have some distinct quality that makes the recruiter want me. Right. I wanted something on my CV. So that wasn't the sole reason for joining FRM, doing FRM, but also my love towards finance. I have had keen interest in finance since I was a child. I had decided that I want to, you know, go into core finance since I gave my HSE as well. So I had been doing research, what all courses I can do, who have value and are well recognized in India and foreign. So FRM was recognized since day one in foreign, but India recently has started recognizing its importance.
Right, right.
It was very much in the, it's up level. So I was like, might as well do it. It's of my interest. It has value. It just ticked everything.
Right, right. So and you cleared the exam in the first attempt itself, and that too in the first year of your college, right?
Right. I cleared the exam in my second year,
right? Because you gave the exam in the January. Sorry. So now, when you started the preparation for the exam, okay, did you had any queries or any inhibition or any worries that okay, I'm in the second year or first year of the college, this is a professional course. What was there any thought process of that sort?
Right. So before you know, even started joining the classes, I had this very big confusion that if I'm eligible for the course or not, because on Google, if you try searching, there are a lot of confusion, like different websites take you to different places where they say a minimum TY graduation is required or something like that. Until you cleared my doubt that it's nothing like that. You can always, you know, being give a student, exam. You can support. The other hurdle was when I entered the class, everyone was either doing a job, had 3-4 years of past experience.
Right.
And I being the youngest, I felt, is it too soon or am I stupid? Or, you know, what is it? Why am I the youngest here?
Okay.
So that was there.
Okay.
But
okay.
I think with time, I got comfortable with it.
Right, right. Because see, the reason I asked you this question is a lot of students who know about the course, who want to go about the course, but might not have the entire clarity of how they can prepare or what all things are required to get the exam cleared. Okay. So that's the reason I asked you this. Right. And
exactly. So when I got your guidance, only after that, you know, I had the strong belief that I can actually move forward with it.
Perfect.
Before
Perfect.
that, I was very unsure that if this is something I can do or not do. Too many thoughts.
Okay. And also, this course will help you for the next level of courses which you're going to be doing, like you're planning for CFA.
Definitely.
So this is going to build that mindset of going for a competitive exam. So that is right. also going to be helpful for you. Now, when you when you started the preparation, okay, so you wanted to go for the November exam, November 2020 exam, and that exam, if I'm not wrong, got cancelled, right? So it got deferred to January. So you got 2 months extra. But when did you start your preparation? The proper preparation started.
I started my preparation on daily basis from July. June, July.
Okay.
I was strict with my schedule from mid-June, July. So I joined the classes back in December to 2019. So I had an option for May attempt, but I wasn't going to give it anyway.
Right.
So that way I was developing the, knowledge on my course since December 2019.
Right.
But then I actually started studying since July or mid-June.
So at least before you went for the November exam, or before you made that payment of $950 in July, you had actually gone through the content and you know what this 60 chapter is about, right? So it gives you
the whole content, but okay. Very basic chapters.
Right.
I knew about those chapters.
Right. Okay, perfect. So now when you started the daily preparation, so how many hours were you dedicating on a daily basis from June?
So, sir, I am a person who works beautifully under pressure. Because you were sitting on my head constantly and taking updates every week, I was under the pressure ki sir ko jawab dena hai. So that is why I work really under pressure. Other than that, I started with 3-4 hours every day.
Okay.
Then with time, the hours increased, of course. And with time towards exam, and I think the hours also decreased, because then in the later stage, I didn't want to take too much pressure. So it was a graph like this.
Okay. So basically,
but there were times when I used to study 8 hours, 9 hours as well.
Right. To get into that flow. But when you started, it was like 3 hours on an average that you were able to dedicate, right? Because you started in June. Basically, you started the proper preparation in June, right? Now, when you picked up the book, okay, was there any particular strategy that you used for clearing the exam? That means, will you go for book one first? Will you go for book two first? Was there any strategy that you used?
So I think I started with book three because as I, read the context or the index, I figured out that book three covers very much the whole jargon of the FR. All the terms and terminologies that were used in all the books were also in book three. So to get used to, the biggest hurdle for me was to adapt the language. Because all those people who were working, they knew everything in and out. But I was looking at the terms for the first time. I was sitting with my Google, reading one line and, finding out 10 different words for meaning.
That's
why I think book three gave me a lot of time and, it's because it talks about everything. It was talking about banks, insurance, futures, forwards. It was also talking a little about quant, everything. It just covered almost everything.
So you started with book three and then you moved to book four, is it?
Book three and book four were going simultaneously.
Right.
Then book
perfect.
Two. And then lastly, I approached to book one.
Book one. Perfect. Now, when you were preparing, so the FRM content has a calculation part also, has a theory part also. Which component you were more comfortable into and where you struggled? And if you struggled, then how you dealt with that?
So, before I used to believe that practical is way easier than theory. But after coming into FRM, I realized you cannot do practical unless you know the theory.
Yes.
So both things in FRM went hands in hand. I have to do the theory part to get to the quants. I have to do the quants to actually understand every word of the theory.
Right.
So if anyone asks me which one is easier, you have to give equal attention to both to, get through it.
And also the calculation part. So what would you say about that? Were you comfortable on the calculator, the usage of the calculator, and you were able to calculate the numbers fast? What was your status?
calculator was the best part. It was very easy, you know, because we were doing it constantly, everyday sums and those things. So I got my hands on it. Calculator thing was good. But a few calculations that we used to do on paper, the diagram, BSM model, and the probability table, those things came with practice.
Right.
So when actually you actually think about it before drawing the diagram, like without drawing the diagram, that comes with practice.
Right. Perfect. So now coming to the last 1 month. Okay. So your exam got deferred. Now you are going to go for the January exam. So before that 1 month, what were you doing in terms of preparation?
The last month was very chaotic because there were 1,000 things in front of me. Ye bhi karna hai, wo bhi karna hai. But end mein you feel ki you do everything. You don't want to, you know, miss out on any one thing.
Right.
So if I remember, I called you one night and I told you, sir, nahi ho raha hai, sir, itna sara main kaise karun? And then you calmed me down ki Bhakti, chill. You will do it. And then you figure out things for me. Okay. So that was my breakdown night that I had. But then that was stress. Things went fine.
So when you had a proper plan, it became easy for you to tackle that 1 month. Because it is about reading the entire 60 chapter together. And also you have a pressure that, okay, this is a big exam. A lot of other people are also preparing heavily. So you have to be...
Other people who are not of my age. That was the biggest pressure. Who are 10 years ahead in life? Those people.
But when I talk to them, they say that, okay, they have... These new guys have an advantage. They know this, knew about this exam in their college. And we never knew about this. They are knowing about this right now. So obviously they have the experience and a lot of things they will be able to pick it up very easily. But you have the luxury of time, which they did not have. So that, I think, so balanced out the entire thing. Now coming to the preparation part during the exam. Okay, what happened in the exam date? So I think so because of the COVID, like not many people were going for the exam. Okay, so this actually made it very tricky because people who are going to be going for the exam are going to be well prepared, will actually take that step to go for the exam. A lot of people cancelled it and they moved to the May exam. Now, in the exam hall, 4 hours, 100 questions. Were you able to solve entire 100 questions properly?
Actually, yes, I was able to. Maybe 1-2 questions I didn't get the time to review. But I was able to solve all the questions.
Okay, perfect. And out of that 100 questions, what do you feel was the range for the quant question or the range for the theory question? And on an average?
I think there were a lot of theory questions this time compared to quants.
Okay. So the reason I asked you this, because see, a lot of people, they feel that FRM is quant heavy. And everything is calculation. Because see, you like I already have always been talking that you might be seeing, say, a standard deviation calculation in your books, but you do not actually get that sum in the exam, right? Because they don't want to waste your time. Okay, everything is, they will try to help you. They will try to and make you a question on the understanding about the concept, right? So those kind of questions were there, right? I mean, theory, which was going to check your understanding.
Right. So one thing I noticed is that how much ever you prepare, the exam was very much unexpected. It wasn't something I expected at all. Like not good unexpected or bad unexpected. It was just, I couldn't have imagined that this is the way the paper was going to look or, you know, these were the questions they were going to target.
Right.
So exam day is a total different thing. But before preparation, if I'd say that you should always concentrate more on theory. Quants, of course, you should practice that all you can. But if you know theory, you know your base. Even if a difficult question comes up, if you know how to solve it, because numbers change all the time.
Right.
So if you know the concept, you will be able to solve it.
Perfect. So now when you were solving that 100 question on that exam day, did you found any difficult question or anything that, okay, I have not seen this question. So if yes, then how did you dealt with that? What was your approach?
There were questions that I thought that I haven't, you know, seen them before. But to be very honest, I break down the question. I, you know, saw the part that I knew. that I know this concept and I know this line, this I have seen somewhere. And then I try to mix both. And then last 10, see, I tell you, 80% of the paper I was able to solve very nicely. Like, okay. I knew everything. 20% of the paper, I think 5% I took chance. 50% thoda sa ye concept ka leke, wo concept ka leke. You know, I tried mismatching stuff and then I did.
Right. So, see, the reason I asked you this questions explicitly is that a lot of students, they come to the mindset that, okay, whatever I've read should come in the exam. No, this is not this normal straightforward exam. This is a global exam. So they will, whatever you would read, this will prepare you for that uncertainty. Like you said, the unexpected part. Yes. So that, right. That all the audience who is going to be looking at this video should also keep in mind that when you go for the exam, uncertainty is the key. You should be able to love the uncertainty and you should not worry about it. Okay. And one more thing, that when you were looking at that question solving, what was your approach? Because it was a paper pencil exam. So did you start from the first question itself or did you start from the middle? What was your way of solving that entire thing?
I started from my first question only.
Mm-hmm.
And then one by one, I used to...
The straight forward, the straight pattern. Okay, because I've seen students who do it from the reverse. Okay, they also do it from that. There are some students who pick up from the middle, or there's students who pick up for the questions which they know and they go for that, those questions first. Now, when you were solving that entire thing, were there any moments where you saw, like, for example, you said 80% of the questions were there. Were there any moments where you solving, you got the answer, but that is not matching with the solution, or the answers are very close? That you, or even if you eliminated questions or eliminated the option, it came down to two options. So were there any such kind of situation? If yes, then out of 100, how many questions you felt that this is happening?
I'd say 5%.
5% of the question.
5 to 10%.
Okay, where you were able to.
Where I was getting double answers, wrong answers. So definitely a lot of questions. Then I solved it again, and then fir correct answer aa gaya. But just say the options are very close, or must have happened because of a silly mistake. So, वैसे I think 5 to 10%.
Perfect. And also, when you solve the paper. Have you solved the GAAP sample paper before the exam?
Yes, I have.
And did you see any similarity with that paper, the real exam paper? No. Okay. In terms
for
of
me, the exam day was very unexpected, sir. So I am telling you, after the exam, I was so blank because I was like, I am not going to pass. I am going to pass. It was nothing to what I expected. But it was only the practice and hard work that I put, you know, made me through the exam.
Okay. Now, so, adding to this point, see, the reason why you might have failed, I'm just putting my thoughts, is that you are comparing yourself with the exam where you might have solved everything and you got 100 or 90. This is not the way this exam would get assessed, okay? Because it's a competitive exam. So even if you're solving out of 20 questions, which is from book one, for example, and you're able to solve 11 or 12 right, and the other guys are also doing equally bad, they're solving 8 and 7, automatically you'll pass that book. So it is more about relative performance than the actual solving. If you're able to do better than the other, then you obviously clear the exam. So that part, I think, so that is where when I also gave the exam, it was not so good that, okay, I'll be clearing the exam 100%, because that is not the nature of the exam. Right. So don't worry about it.
I don't think it was bad. It was just unexpected.
You were not 100% sure. That's what basically you can summarize.
Because it was also my first competitive exam. I haven't given such an exam before.
Right. And I would like to tell this to audience that, okay, even if you're going for something new for the first time, you can still clear it. You only need a proper preparation way, proper solving of question bank. And question bank is the key for level one, because the more you solve, it gives you so much confidence in terms of looking at the question, the timing of the questions. Because I've been telling you guys to time yourself when you solve the question, because even if it is paper pencil, you will never know when you give 15 minutes to the question and then you realize I'm not getting the answer. So that pressure generally happens. But now, since this is primarily the computer-based exam now, so that part will slightly get changed in the going for, again, future. Now, once you cleared the exam, once you got the news, just a general question. Did you see any recognition coming to your way? I know you're still in college. You not be the case where students say that, okay, I got new job or some new remuneration or something like that. In terms of you, was there any recognition among your circle?
Definitely, sir. Definitely. My parents' eyes were filled with pride. Okay. All the relatives and all the friends were so shocked that actually I cleared it. Because with me, like, you know, my whole family was sitting with me and, you know, checking the result. And when I was jumping around. But after impact also, everyone was so impressed because, you know, being too young, I cleared it. So everyone had huge respect for me. It wasn't because I had FRM clear, but it was because I cleared in first attempt and being so young. So these two were, you know, very big.
And more importantly, you proved yourself. Basically, you took a decision in life and you proved yourself that, okay, I because this exam requires your dedication. The amount is also very high. So that, I think so, proved you for the exam. So
despite
I think so.
Despite of a few downfalls, I stick to the plan and then I made it through.
Perfect. Yeah. So now if anybody who is in the college or second year or third year, if he's planning to go for the exam and he comes to you for any advice, what is that advice that you would give to him?
Actually, it is not that difficult. People say, you know, quant stuff hai, ye hai. It looks tough because we're seeing it for the first time. It is not that difficult, to be very honest. After, you know, with practice and once you keep reading that language, it becomes easy with time. So give it thoda time to, you know, adapt the book, give the book some time, and then things will go very easily. So initially when I was solving, you know, question banks, I used to call you after every question. He said, ye nahi samajh raha hai, wo nahi samajh raha. And I was so, you know, depressed at that time ki 10 questions, mein se 8 questions, to mujhe question hi nahi samajh raha. Forget about the solving. I was not understanding the language only. But with time, it became very easy. And by the end, though, it is not that difficult how much people, you know, say it by... Just by saying, people make it very difficult. It's not that easy and you can always do it.
Right.
You just need proper guidance, which I got.
Thank you. And I would like to add one point. See, a lot of people, they do not clear the exam because they don't stick to that plan. They do not have the patience to just sideline their job for some time, some other commitment and sit for the exam, sit for that preparation for that 3-4 months. And then the result will come. That patience has actually been tested in that period. And that is the value of this exam, that you, when you get the result and you realize, okay, I've cleared the exam. So wonderful, Bhakti. And thank you very much for sharing your experience, the entire thing, because this video or this interview, I think so, was going to be very helpful for students, especially people now who are looking to do this course, even immediately after 12th, because they don't want to waste time. Okay. Because there are other courses they can only do in the third year or after the graduation. So this 2 years, they can do at least something. So this your entire journey and the confidence that you have shown in the exam also is going to help them in their preparation. And definitely we would look forward to do such sessions again in the future with you, where you can guide our students in a live session and help them, sharing your experience about the topic, about the content. Right. So thank you very much for joining.
Thank you so much for having.
Thank you.
Thank you.